everyone. Okay, so today we're going to focus on object control for our adapted PE elementary level learners. We will be working on the underhand toss. Now, the underhand toss is super important to learn because it's used in so many sports and activities, and luckily easy enough to learn right at home. So, we're going to get right into learning the correct way to do an underhand toss. So I'm hoping you guys can all see me. We're going to learn how to do the underhand toss. Now, the movements are going to be you swing your arm forward, you swing your arm back, you step with the opposite leg, and you swing and release. So let's try it together. We're going to swing our arm forward, swing our arm back. We're going to step with the opposite leg, swing, and release. Awesome. Now, these cues can sometimes be a little hard to remember. So something that I like to use to remember the cues of doing an underhand toss is called tick, tock, step, and rock. So, for tick, tock, step, and rock, we're just going to do the same thing, but just say tick, tock, step, and rock. So you got tick, tock, step with the opposite leg, and rock. Let's do it together. Ready? Tick, tock, step, and rock. Awesome. So that's same as the other cues for the skill, but this one is just fun to remember. So it will definitely stick in your mind of how to do the underhand toss every time because it's a fun way to. Okay, so now since we have the cues and techniques down, we're going to practice our underhand tossing. So we can find many household objects to use as a ball for underhand tossing. So for a beginner-friendly level, we can use a simple plastic bag. We can use a balloon, a beach ball. For more of an intermediate level, we can use like a crumpled up piece of paper. I have here a rolled up ball of socks, or if you guys have a tennis ball at home, or even like a soft squishy ball, that could also be used for our underhand tossing. So, I'm going to start out by using the plastic bag just to show you guys. Ready? So we're going to forward, swing our arm back, step with the opposite leg, toss, and release. And again, we're going to tick, tock, step, and rock. All right, now with our rolled up ball of socks, it's going to go a little faster. So we're going to forward, back, step, release. And again, we're going to tick, tock, step, and rock. All right. That is awesome. Now, a good note to make while doing this activity is just to switch up the objects for your learner at home, just to keep the child engaged as much as possible. So it could be an object of different colors, bright colors, shapes, sizes, just things so they don't lose concentration. Now, after we're done practicing our underhand toss and we feel comfortable enough to move to the next step, we're just going to add in some homemade attainable targets just for fun. So behind me I have a laundry basket, a bucket, a paper plate, and a box. So my targets range in shapes and sizes, difficulty levels. To make things more difficult, you can start by standing close to your targets and moving further away if you still feel the need to. Another target, if you have a family member home with you, they can also put their arms together like a ring for a basket, and that could also be a target if you don't have any household objects around. Try and challenge yourselves. But don't challenge yourselves until you fully understand how to do the underhand toss. Now, I hope this video helps you guys. I hope you do your underhand toss awesome at home. And I hope you have a great rest of the day.